Good morning, my dear students. Today we will continue our chapter employment. We will discuss today informalization of workforce. Since independence, the main objective of Indian planning is to raise the standard of living of the people by providing job and job security. It has been stressed that industrialization would bring surplus workers from agriculture to industry with better standard of living. Even after 55 years of planned development, 3/5 of Indian workforce depends upon agriculture as the major source of livelihood. Over the years, the quality of employment has deteriorated. Even after working of more than 10 to 20 years, some workers do not get maternity benefit, provident fund, gratuity and pension. Employees in the private sector get a lower salary as compared to employees doing the same work in the public sector. The employment structure in India can be studied with respect to two kinds of sectors: formal sector, informal sector. Yes, students, informalization of workforce is defined as a situation where percentage of workforce in the formal sector tends to decline and that in the informal sector tends to rise. Now we will discuss classification of workforce, formal sector and informal sector. Formal sector or organized sector: all the public sector establishments and those private sector establishments which employ 10 hired workers or more are called formal sector establishments, and those who work in such establishments are formal sector workers. These sectors are registered by government and they follow rules and regulations laid by the government, such as Factories Act, Minimum Wages Act, Payment of Gratuity Act, Shops and Establishment Act. Organized sector always follow some formal processes and procedures. Like, while hiring, employer should give appointment letter to employee. Employee get a regular salary at the end of the month. Employer cannot ask the employee to leave the service without a valid reason. Those who are working in the formal sector enjoy the following benefits: social security, job security, good salary, fixed time working, overtime is given for extra time working, paid leave, paid holidays, medical benefits, provident fund, safe drinking water and safe working environment. Examples of organized sectors are government organizations, MNCs. Informal sectors or unorganized sector: all other enterprises and workers working in those enterprises from the informal sector. Informal sector includes millions of farmers, agricultural laborers, owners of small enterprises, and the people working in those enterprises as the self-employed who do not have any hired workers. It includes all non-farm casual wage laborers who work for more than one employer, such as construction workers and head load workers. Features of informal sector: workers and enterprises in the informal sector do not get regular income. They do not have any protection or regulation from the government. workers are dismissed without any compensation. Technology used in the informal sector enterprises is outdated. They do not maintain any accounts. Workers of this sector live in slums and are squatters. Yes, friends, we can see this chart. Yes, friends, there are about 473 million workers in the country, we have discussed earlier. There are about 30 million workers in the formal sector. We will take percentage 30 upon 473 into 100. It is only 6%. 6% workers are in the formal sector. Rest 94% are in the informal sector. Out of 30 million formal sector workers, only 6 million, that is only 21%, are women. In the informal sector, male workers account for 69% of the workforce. Yes, friends. Since the late 1970s, many developing countries, including India, started paying attention to enterprises and workers in the informal sector. As employment in the formal sector is not growing, workers of this, owing to these efforts of the international labor organizations, the Indian government has initiated the modernization of informal sector enterprises and provision of social security measures to informal sector workers. Thank you.